is Rachel Tessman from StampYourArtOut.com, and today I'd like to introduce you to the September 2014 My Paper Pumpkin Kit from Stampin' Up, titled Boo-tiful Bags. This kit has everything that you need, including the stamps and the ink, to make 6 decorated 5x3 burlap bags for Halloween goodies. The directions with photos are included in the kit, and Stampin' Up! Even posts their own video so that you can watch step-by-step how to assemble the paper pumpkin kit contents according to the directions given. Now, in my videos, I like to show you how to think outside the box. I show alternate ways to use the kit contents to create all sorts of fun projects, and I share many of my ideas in videos and on my blog. And then I also share other project ideas privately with my personal paper pumpkin subscribers. Check this one out. Not a subscriber yet? You'll want to be after checking out what you can create with these very affordable kits. Pages, kid projects. In this video, I'll be sharing 6 alternate ideas, including scrapbook pages and a fun project for kids to make when they've put together all their bags. Because you have to admit, this kit already is a great one for the kids. Any extra tools that I use in this video can be purchased from me in my online store. So let's get started. To make the bags according to the kit directions, all you need are some candies to put inside the bag, a scissors, and then you need, of course, your clear block to mount your stamps. I like to lay my stamps on the table so they don't have any quick little curves in them, and then I pick them up with the block that way. And there's our fun little bag. Here's another version. This one has chocolates, this one has saltwater taffy. You choose. All right, another fun thing to do with the bags is to treat them as if they are not bags, but instead a piece of clothing. So we're gonna tear off or cut off. You wanna cut off the burlap part. I don't know if you can tear that off. And then we're gonna grab some really thin cellophane bags that you can get in the Stampin' Up! Online store. And we just start inserting candies into these bags. There we go. And close that down. And then we're gonna grab 2 of these. We're gonna turn them around. And we're gonna flip them upside down so that our candy wrapper closure is at the bottom. And these parts are gonna go inside the bag. And then we grab some sequin trim. That just becomes a nice little embellishment because an embellishment for what? Because little dresses, see, here's the feet, here's the legs. Little dresses need to have sequins. Every girl needs sequins on their dress. So these are little dress bags. Aren't they adorable?
Aren't they cute?
Okay, here's another idea. Just a simple card, very easy card. So you take your stamps and your stickers and your twine and your sequin, and you get your cardstock out and you cut it and score it, stamp it, put it together and make just some simple, nice cards with all of your stamps, because you're gonna have that stamp set, you're gonna have that ink, and it's gonna be left over and you're gonna need to make other things with it. You don't wanna just set it aside and never use it again. So how did we do that? Well, I have an embossing folder that makes this tree pattern onto cardstock. You just take and slip your paper inside there and you crank it through our Sizzix Big Shot machine, or you could use the Texture Boutique. An idea, if you don't want to put texture on your paper, you certainly don't have to. Here's another version of the same sort of card, a little stepped up in a different way. Instead, I put sequins left over, because did you see that when I cut the sequin trim, all these little things started flying off at the ends? That's because they're just strung on there, and so you're gonna get these little pieces that stray off of the sequin trim. And you'll grab those and you'll stick those on with these glue dots. These little bats. Oh, this is such a fun idea. I found this on Pinterest. So you take butterfly punches and you first punch down low on your cardstock, and that gets rid of just the top portion of your butterfly. But then you come in a little bit higher, make sure it's even. And can you see that? I'm not sure. Let's see if I can bring it up high. There we go. So what I've done is I've punched it out again, and I've just got the top portion of the butterfly, and I've created a bat. Here you can do that again with the smaller butterfly punch that we also carry in our store. And there's the smaller bat. Genius! Don't know who came up with that, but I love it. So that's how you create those bats. Now, if you want to put the sequin trim behind and you don't want it falling all over the place, then what you'll want to do is use some super strong adhesive. And we sell a couple different kinds now. My favorite has become the Fast Fuse. And by the way, it is on sale through October 6, 2014. So if you're watching this video right when I put it out, you can take advantage of that sale and get this and refills for it for 15% off. This is another type of adhesive that we sell. It's called Sticky Strip. And it's very strong, very, very strong. Both of these are. You'll just stick this down. You'll trim off a piece like that. And then you take the backing off. And it's that quick and easy. You just want to make sure you use a sticky adhesive. This adhesive is just as sticky. You run it like that, and then you make sure that you flick it to twist it to come off. And it's just as sticky as the other stuff. So
I did,
because I like to create, I decided that I was going to scrapbook the Project Life pieces. So let me pull those items out here and talk about each one.
I embossed it. Again, you wouldn't need to. So if you don't want to invest in the Texture Boutique embossing tool or the Big Shot tool to use folders like this, or like this one here, which is what I used on this particular piece, then you can just put it in as is. You don't have to add texture to your cardstock. But first, if you're going to stamp onto cardstock, you want to stamp first and then emboss. This is half of one of the tags that comes in the kit. I just stuck it down with some basic adhesive. The basic adhesive of my choosing is the snail adhesive that we sell. This is a nice one to use. I also used Memento ink that comes in the tuxedo black, and so I did add an ink color to these pages. Stamp the Eat Something Sweet here, and then I punched with a banner punch, but again, you could hand cut out of your Blackberry Bliss cardstock or out of your tag. You can just cut some little banners and then put your stickers on there. And I purposely, don't know if you can tell that from here, but I purposefully made those stickers come off the banners so that you can tell that they're stickers and not just stamps. Then my favorite embellishment, which all my Paper Pumpkin subscribers need to have, and if they don't, oh my gosh, it's a sad, sad world. It's these rhinestones. And the rhinestones come in clear, but you can color them with any kind of permanent marker, such as Sharpie markers, Blendabilities, which we sell. They work really well on our rhinestones now. But I just used a black Sharpie marker because that does not come in black in our Blendabilities. And I colored each rhinestone so it has a nice dark shine to it. Okay, another piece that I put on my page. This one was fun and super simple. All I did was sponge the top of my piece of Tangelo Twist cardstock. And this is cut to 3x4. The other one was 4x6. And then I wrapped some of the twine around, stuck it down with just some regular tape from 3M, and then I stuck a black sticker down, and then I stamped the matching bird stamp, because you get that bird stamp in the kit too, with the color that comes in the kit. Okay, this one I don't think I want to pull out, but I will hold it up because it has sequin pieces in it that will fall all over the place. And I purposefully put them in there like that so that when someone's looking through my scrapbook page, they can see all this fun movement So there's the extra sequins from the trim, stamped Happy Halloween on one of the tags, but I used the black ink, so that's something I added, and then the black cardstock, which is something I added to the kit. 3x4 size again. Here's a 3x4 size of the basic gray. I embossed it to match the other basic gray piece. Then I took one of our tags and I cut it into thin strips, and I attached it. Here, I can possibly show this to you. I attached it together with a piece in the middle. I added a circle punch and another circle punch that's scalloped on the edges to make that stand out, but you wouldn't necessarily need to do that. You could just take and cut a piece of cardstock out, square, shape, whatever, and stamp your little image down. All right, this one is super fun. Let me show you how to make this little guy. And you've got an eyeball. Yay! Isn't that fun and gross at the same time? Okay, so I just stuck that little eyeball down on a half a tag, took some twine, tied it into a little bow or knot, and then I stuck it on with a glue dot. And this is more of that Tangello twist cardstock that I sponged with color. The last piece on the Project Life page is this one. I used a 4x6 black base. Then I put on top of it, I can't remember the size. Let me measure it. Hey, my wonderful handy dandy grid paper. 3.5x4 inch Blackberry Bliss piece. I stamped that bat stamp that comes in your kit in the black tuxedo black memento ink all over the place on the purple on that Blackberry Bliss paper. Then I used just a half of a tag here and stuck that down. Put one of these on, and I made these into eyes too. I guess I'm into eyeballs this time. So eyeballs, eyeballs. Fun, fun, fun. And that's the Project Life page. And all of it assembled once again looks like this. All right, the next idea is a fun idea for your kiddos. You get this cardboard little piece that comes in the bottom of your box. Or inside your box to hold all your supplies together. And we're going to take the Stampin' Spot, the ink pad, and we're just going to go around all the edges to make it look messy and scary. Next, you take your marker or your crayon or whatever black tool you have, and you write in nice big letters to let everyone know in your family that you want privacy. It's a door sign. And there you have it. You have a sign for your door that tells your brothers, sisters, mom and dad, whoever, to keep out. Now you could also take and make your own sign that's a little bit more welcoming. A trick-or-treat sign for your door. Trick-or-treat with little sequins glue dotted on. Okay, the last idea. Last idea is the scrapbook page. I took a large piece of 12x12 Blackberry Bliss. And one of the labels. I also took and punched out with the 2.5 inch circle punch some of the honey color from this collection of colors. But here's the thing, if you don't have that punch, just take and trace a glass, the top of a glass, onto your paper using a pencil and a drinking glass, and then trim around and you have a perfect circle. That's the way I remember doing it as a kid when we didn't have these handy dandy punches. Now this is the piece that you punch your tag out of, and I just trimmed off the excess around it, and that's going to be like a photo strip that sits behind here. I also took some of the Mossy Meadow cardstock. Hello Honey, that's the name of it. I also took some of this cardstock, and this is a 5-inch piece, and I tore it so that I had 2 inches on one side, 3 inches on the other. I'm overlapping them, and that looks like grass. And then I took another piece, because if you get two 5-inch pieces from that 12-inch paper, then you'll have another 2-inch section at the top left over. And I tore that in half, so I got a 1-inch piece here. And so that becomes our little ground cover. These tags, just they look like tombstones, so why not stick a couple tombstones in there? And of course we want stickers, and we want the sequin trim on our pages somewhere, so I will add those in a minute. Let's look at the other
Okay, paper. Here's that other piece of that strip that we cut from.
That goes on this page. More of the grassy ground. And that's exactly how you do it. It's super simple to make a ground. And here is the other bottom piece. Two more pieces that look like tombstones, and we'll tuck those in, and I'll be right back. All right, so this is what I ended up with. I have my title up here. I put a couple sequins inside the word boo to make them look like eyes. I also, I'm not sure if you can tell here, but I put notches in there with my scissors, just like I did on the signs, so that I could wrap the twine around and tie it in a bow. Put it up on dimensionals, and then I've put a couple more sequins around the boo, put some bat stickers on the sky area, especially over the moon. Put more sequins on glue dots that were on the little photo strips there. Then you can see at the bottom I have a tombstone that is layered on one of the gray striped background pieces, the tags, a bird in front, and then if you look, trees in the background, some sequin trim on the bottom. And then on the matching page, I have similar things on this side. I put the skull and crossbones on one of the tombstones. These tombstones here that are in vanilla color are meant for journaling so that I can write some things about the photos I add to the page. And then over here, a little bit further in the background, beyond the tombstones, I stuck a skull that has a little bit of that Hello Honey color behind it so that it matches the moon, carries some of the yellow over onto the other side, and makes the eyes and the nose glow as if the skull is alive and coming out of the ground. Spooky! Okay, so I'm gonna zoom out just a little bit here so you can see the spread. It's not perfect, but so I got my tripod in the way. But you could also change the order of the pages. I think either way on these would look very decent. So there's our pages, our 12 by 12 traditional pages, our 12 by 12 Project Life pages, or page. But I say pages because you could actually take these pieces and spread them out into more page protectors so that you get more bang for your buck. The signs for the doors, keep out and trick or treat. These fun candy bags with the dresses, the legs, and the shoes. A couple card ideas. Remember the bats made out of the butterfly punches. Love, love, love that idea. And then, of course, can't forget the eyeball done with the circle punches and the tree stamp. And then, of course, the bags that you're supposed to make with the kit. So fun. Lots of ideas there. Thank you for watching. It builds creativity to think outside the box. Be sure to go to my YouTube channel and subscribe so that you can catch more paper pumpkin videos that I have shared using past kits and more that I'll share with future kits. Also, be sure to visit my blog at stampyourartout.com so that you can view close-up photos of all these items and see photos of other paper pumpkin kit ideas. Do you want to see more? Well, then you need to get your paper pumpkin subscription started with me as your demonstrator to see some exclusive projects. Yay! I hope you all enjoyed this video tutorial. Now I'd like you all to go and stamp your art out. Bye-bye.